magic spell you cast. This is love, oh. Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. My name is Swasti. If you're new to my channel, then please don't forget to check out my other videos and subscribe to my channel down below. And today's video is something jo I have been thinking about for such a long time, but I waited for a very long time so that I was 100% sure that I wanted to do this video. And of the things that I wanted to talk about in this video, you already know from the title, I am talking about menstrual cups. So I even asked on Instagram certain things that you might want to know about menstrual cups, or if you have ever used a menstrual cup and what is your experience about it. Most people who have used a menstrual cup say that it took them one or two tries, but after that, once they got the hang of it, there's literally no going back. I have a very similar review about that. There were 2-3 people who said that they were too intimidated by it, so they even bought it, but you know, they couldn't really use it. And a few were also there who said that they tried it, but it did not work out for them. So just like for everything else in this world, for this as well, there are many different reviews, and I'm just going to be talking about my personal experiences using a menstrual cup. What are the benefits of it? What are the risks of it? Why did I make the switch? And I will also be showing how to use the menstrual cup. I will give you a small demo, and I hope that helps you guys a lot. I have also divided the video into different parts, and you will see like markings. So in case you're not interested to know about a certain thing and you just want to see how to use, you can just skip to the part that you are interested in. If you don't know what a menstrual cup is basically this little cup which is made of silicone or latex, which you put into your vagina and it holds your blood. That is simply what a menstrual cup is. Let's start with why did I make the switch to menstrual cups. I used to use pads. I have been using pads since class 9 was the time when I got my first period, and I have been using pads ever since. Till last year in June 2020, I've been thinking about menstrual cups for a very long time, but as like most of us, I was very intimidated by it, and I was like, I don't know, will I be able to use, is it actually meant for me? I was very confused and I had a lot of questions regarding menstrual cups. So I was like, I don't know, I'm not sure. I was looking for alternatives for pads, because the thing was, pads were very, very expensive, and it's just not worth it, because even after using a pad, I can't opt for a cheaper pad because they are not as good in quality, and it was a bomb on the pocket. I was like, it's too expensive, and you know, even after that, there's odor issues. I was getting rashes because I live in a humid climate, so I was getting a lot of rashes. It was very uncomfortable. So I thought, okay, theek hai, ek bar try to kari sakte, menstrual cup kya hai? If it does not work out, I already have my pads, that's okay. So I decided to order a menstrual cup from PSafe. Actually, the first one that I got was a different size, because I did not check the size, and I ordered like a large, which was meant for like women who have given birth and all of that, or who have like a very deep cervix. Before that, I did not even research this much that what size I need or anything. That was very stupid of me. I did not research that, and then I realized, shit, galat size ho gaya. So then I went ahead and then I had to exchange it, and then I got the perfect size. This is the small one. That is why I made the switch, mostly because pads were getting too expensive for me and they were very, very, very uncomfortable. So I had to make the switch. And obviously I'm aware of the environmentally kitna kharab hota hai pads, and you know how menstrual cups are much better because they are reusable. So that angle was there, but more than that, it was like the expense and the comfort. But next, let's move on to what are the benefits of using a menstrual cup. So like I already mentioned, menstrual cups are super affordable. They are way safer than tampons. With tampons, there's a possibility of getting the toxic shock syndrome, which does not exist with menstrual cups. At least that's what I've heard. I have no idea. I've never used tampons, so I don't know. A menstrual cup holds more blood than pads or tampons do. And of course, it is sustainable and it is much better for the environment, because one cup can easily last you for 2 years, aram se. And if you have two and you alternate between the months, it's sustainable and it's easy on the pocket. You don't spend a bomb on stuff like this. So those are the basic benefits of menstrual cups. What are certain risks or like disadvantages of using menstrual cups? Now, I googled and researched a lot. I haven't found a risk of menstrual cups. Like, I have googled a lot, and you know, I've tried to find out ki kya risks ho sakta hai, because you know, it might have a risk, but अभी तक मेरे को कोई भी रिस्क एज सच नहीं मिला है. बट इफ यू नो ऑफ अ रिस्क, एज यू एक्चुअली नो ऑफ अ रिस्क विच इज रियल एंड एवरीथिंग, then do let me know in the comments down below, because as far as I have researched, there are no risks involved. There are certain disadvantages, of course. The first one is it gets messy. So yeah, even for me personally, like, I'm not comfortable with seeing blood like that, right? So for me, it was for the first few, like first cycle at least, for my first month, it was very shocking, sort of. It was not very comfortable, like, seeing that blood, because you have to take it out and then discharge that blood. You have to throw that blood away, clean it up and all of that. So it might get messy. It doesn't get like messy in the washroom as such if you're careful, but it might. So that is obviously there, because the blood is literally right there. So it might get messy. That is one disadvantage. Next is that it might be hard to insert or remove. Now this is again the thing that people find it very intimidating to put it in or take it out, because the thing is, no one can actually give you like a close-up tutorial of how to do it, right? Thoda sa tension to rehta hai that am I putting it in or not. So people might find it hard and intimidating to do that. Of course, that is a risk. Even I found it really intimidating to do that, but again, I got over the fear, and it takes like one or two tries to get the hang of it. But I think if you do get the hang of it, then I don't think there's turning back and going back to pads ever again. So yeah, apart from that, of course, it completely depends on your personal hygiene. So if you don't keep your cup clean, if you don't wash it on time, if you do not sterilize it, of course there's a chance that you might get an infection. That chance remains for literally everything that is related to your area. You know, if you don't clean it well, if you don't keep it clean, it will develop an infection. That's a given. So please make sure to keep it clean. But apart from that, as I said, these were the three risks that I have found. Even on Google, my personal experience mein toh, touch wood, abhi tak I haven't found any risk. But yeah. Now, next, coming to my personal experience using a menstrual cup. Okay, as I said, the first time I ordered the wrong size. So I was like, it's too big. I was very scared. Should I put it in? Should I not? But when I got this cup, it got super easy for me. And literally, I was so scared that I actually, before my period started, I wore this for like 2 hours or something, and I let that be. Putting it in was a task, I will not lie. Of course it was a task, because I was so unsure ki wo hua hai, is it sticking, is it not sticking, am I putting it right. I was very unsure, and for I think 10 to 15 minutes I could feel a little discomfort, because I was like, you know, there's something down there, I could feel that. But once I removed my mind from it, it got so comfortable. It sort of found its own place, and then very comfortable. And literally, I remember on my second day of my first or second day of my period, I just sent my best friend a message that, dude, this is like the best thing ever. Because for me, not like, it was like I forgot completely about the fact that I had my period, right? Everything down there was dry. Okay, there was no leakage, there was no gila gila feeling, there was no odor, no rashes. Okay, it was amazing for me. I really got so excited after my first month that I was like, okay, I don't mind periods that much anymore. For me, making the switch to menstrual cups made my life and made my periods easier by like 20 times or something like that. How to use a menstrual cup? The biggest question everyone has, right? How do you use this little thing? It's very simple. I will show you in a demo with a bottle. But before that, the first thing that you have to do is make sure you sterilize it right after you get it. Before using it, just sterilize it with water. The next thing, and you should also sterilize it before and after your cycles. Now, a lot of people find it hard to insert this because it's not lubricated, right? So everything is dry, this is dry, it causes an issue. What you do is just make sure, if you have a water-based lube, then use that. If not, then make sure to cover the rim with a little bit of water, like just thoda water laga lo, so that this is lubricated with water. Then there are many different types of folds, but the one that I personally use is like, this is like a C fold, I think. This is called like a 3-fold or something. It's like you just put your finger here and you fold it, and it forms this shape, and ye angular rahega, and you just put it in. After you put it in, dheere dheere isko kholo, so it will ye iske suction ka and vacuum ka ek awaaz aayega, type ka. If you hear that sound, that means this has been secured in place and that is literally all you have to do. Sometimes kya hota hai, fold pura khul nahi paata hai. So in that case, you just make sure to press it on the ends and you know, agar aise hai to usko अगर एंड्स में हम लोग ऐसे ऐसे प्रेस करेंगे तो वो धीरे धीरे खुल जाएगा.
लाइक आई शोड अर्लियर, यू जस्ट मेक द एंगुलर फोल्ड एंड यू हैव टू इंसर्ट इट इन. आई एम डेमोन्स्ट्रेटिंग इट विद अ बॉटल. इट्स सॉर्ट ऑफ सिमिलर एंड यू नो आई हैड टू प्रेस इट ऑन द बेस फॉर इट टू ओपन अप अ लिटिल, बट इट हैपन्स एंड दैट इज हाउ यू रिमूव इट. यू जस्ट प्रेस एट द बेस एंड यू रिमूव इट इजिली. आई ऑल्सो शो यू विद अ लिटिल वाटर इनसाइड. एज यू कैन सी, you know, nothing comes out, it's leak proof. It does get a little messy while you're taking it out, so you have to be careful. You can do it over the commode.
Obviously it will depend upon your flow, but you can keep this for around say for 6 to 8 hours. Even on like my heaviest flow days, it lasts me for around say for 5 to 6 hours, even on my like heaviest flow wala days. This particular cup retails for 300 rupees, and as I said, around 160-200 rupees I spend on each month ka pads. Okay, so even if I say that 150 I spend, 150 to minimum anyone spends on pads for 1 month, I think. So you know, 2 mahine ke kharche mein, 2 mahine ke pad ke kharche mein, you will get this cup which will last you around say 2 years. So yeah, that was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and it was informative and helpful to you. If it was, then please do give it a thumbs up, comment down below and let me know if you have any questions regarding menstrual cups. I am also making a video answering the questions that you had regarding menstrual cups. That video will go up tomorrow. So do not forget to subscribe to my channel and watch that video as well to get even more clarity on menstrual cups. And yeah, stay home, stay healthy, stay safe and take care of yourself. Bye.